$1,050,000 to be handed out with zero strings attached as guaranteed income pilot comes to another U.S. city. People who are facing financial hardships can soon apply for the new program called GRIT in Tacoma, Washington. So the project will give 175 families $500 a month for 12 consecutive months to qualify. Each family's income must be above 100% of the federal poverty line and below 200%. So, and I got a question for you. It led me to a question because I realize, Anthony, what your point is, we have all this money for Ukraine, but we don't have enough money for our own people. So this is good. It's not bad. When do we help the people that are above the poverty line, but barely? And the reason I bring that up, because there's a whole bunch of people that are food insecure. You just said how expensive it is in Arizona. They're not at 200% say of the poverty line, but say they're just a little bit over. I was poking around looking for stuff that was important for today. And I found that Arizona's governor, Katie Hobbs, is apparently forgiving a bunch of healthcare debt for people to the tune of $2 million. So she's canceling, or I'm sorry, billion, not million, amateur. So
are
she's
you on that list?
No, I am not. This is redistribution of wealth is what it is. This is communism, socialism, light. I mean, I know it's helpful for people, but we just went through 3 months of medical hell in our family. Ambulance ride, skilled nursing facility, hospital, doctors, MRIs, CAT scans, blood work, shots, breathing treatments. We went through everything. I am sitting with a pile of bills. I don't meet the parameters to fall within this $2 billion. But I'll tell you what, these bills, this is insane what I have to pay. So is it jealousy? Am I jealous of the people that make slightly less than I do? I mean, I don't know. When you forgive medical bills for some and not others, it's just, it gets old. I don't know. I mean, I don't know the answer. That's part of my problem with all this.
Said it. It's like, if we're communist light right now, like you can call capitalism what you want, but it's gone to that direction where it's the haves versus the have nots. So you know how this works is if people got paid, if you got paid enough to pay your own bills and pay these wages, then you don't have to have all the government assistance. But you've got these large corporations and these politicians, which are hoarding the funds for themselves. We had a client say that once, and that always stuck with me. There's only so much you can spend and that buy. And even that money is not real. We say that all the time. To say Elon Musk is worth $100 billion, well, how is he worth $100 billion? Or does he own stocks and shares and assets that are of that evaluation? But those change. You have to get rid of stuff at a high to have the cash for when things are low. These guys know that. They're seeing peaks. So they're getting out what they can while they can so that they can increase their wealth significantly more when things are down again.
I'm glad you brought that up. Let me hit a couple of things with that. You know, if people sell assets right now, as we speak, some of these very wealthy people are in the process of doing so. Warren Buffett selling Apple stock, Jamie Dimon selling JP Morgan stock, Mark Zuckerberg with his Facebook Meta stock, Jeff Bezos with Amazon. The number I read yesterday was just what's already been sold in the last couple of weeks, $9 billion in stock. These wealthy people, when you talk about there's no money, it's funny money, go on usdebtclock.org, $34 trillion in debt. The average is another $1 trillion every 100 days. So that means roughly 4 trillion a year is going to be added on. It can just go forever, right, Anthony? I mean, no worries.